assignment, I will be looking at two similar principles of chemistry, the Maillard reaction and the process of caramelization. In 1912, a French chemist discovered this reaction while attempting to reproduce biological synthesis. The Maillard reaction, named after the French chemist, is a chemical reaction between amino acids and sugars that gives browned foods their distinctive flavors. Chemical mechanisms of the reaction occur as follows. Number one, a molecular group formed from a carbon atom and an oxygen atom, known as a carbonyl group in organic chemistry, reacts with an amino acid, producing a nitrogen-containing compound and water. Next, this nitrogen compound undergoes a particular rearrangement and forms ketosamines, which is a mix between ketone and amine groups. Finally, ketosamines can undergo a few reactions, with the final products being fission products, reductones, and hydroxymethylfurfural. As seen in the cooking demonstration, seared steaks, as well as a number of other foods such as fried dumplings, baked goods, and toasted marshmallows undergo this reaction. The reaction is a form of non-enzymatic browning, which occurs from about 140 degrees Celsius to 165 degrees Celsius. At higher temperatures, caramelization occurs. The Maillard reaction produces different organic compounds. Those contribute to different flavors and aromas. These flavor profile terms can include nutty, astringent, cereal-like, and roasted, as seen on the right-hand side. Another process related to the Maillard reaction is that of caramelization. This reaction is the browning of sugar, which is extensively used in cooking for the sweet, nutty flavor and the brown color of desserts. As caramelization occurs, volatile chemicals such as diacetyl are released, giving the foods the distinct caramel flavor. The chemistry of the reaction involves the evaporation of water and the breakdown of sugars. The caramelization reaction depends on the type of sugar. For example, if the sugar is maltose, it will break down into two glucose molecules. If the sugar is lactose, it will break down into one glucose molecule and one galactose molecule. And if the sugar is sucrose, it will break down into one glucose molecule and one fructose molecule. Similar to the Maillard reaction, caramelization is a form of non-enzymatic browning. However, this reaction is pyrolytic, meaning thermal decomposition is involved, rather than a reaction with amino acids. This appears to be the largest difference between the two processes.